sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father, you were chosen for the Son. Thank you.
are here to celebrate Thanksgiving Mass for the wonderful life of Rose Mead. In the name of Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the water of baptism, Rose died with Christ and rose with him into new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Bless and pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Rose, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Now the first reading will be read by Sarah.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if in the eyes of men indeed they be punished, yet it is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is in his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
reading from the book of John. See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Dear friends, now we are children of God, and what we will be has not yet been made known. But we know that when Christ appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Receiving special resting time a word time in heaven. You and I, we are in a journey. Every one of us has different gifts. So we have to use those gifts. Younger kids, they have different gifts. They are living 21st century. But above all is moral life. If you are losing moral life, you are losing everything. You and me, every one of us. Moral life is more important. Because we receive from God the gift of free will. We can do good or bad. And we know we can do this, good and bad. But we are on this earth to do good. If we are doing bad, we are coming to the church telling Jesus, be merciful to me. I am a very weak person. And today, when we came to say goodbye to Rose, our soul of this community, because she was born here. She was born here in Oakville on September 26, 1927. Soon will be almost 97 years of age. So I can say, she was our child of this community. So I put this stole of Saint Cecilia. Saint Cecilia. Because she is the patron of a musician. So this is the reason why Rose received the gift of music. And through music, the gifts of languages. Because if you have good hearing, you will be also good person for languages. So she spoke many languages. She was gifted with language. Even in the schools, so French was his primary teaching. Of course, English. And also, she taught Latin. Above all, Italian, because she came from Italian's roots, and Spanish. What kind of blessing for every person on this earth to speak many languages. This is the gift. So I am very crazy about languages. If some people, they have connection with different countries, they should teach children those languages from childhood or in the school. This is a gift. And I know in this Batavia community is many people with the roots from Italy. Beautiful roots of family life, church life. And you have to be very close to the church because you have different roots. We cannot put poison in our roots. Because we'll be like nothing. Oh, every church is okay. No, every faith is okay. It's not. Of course, it's okay. Some ways. But we have to fight in this 21st century for our faith. Can you imagine to fight for our faith in 21st century? And Rose lived in different time, even during that depression as a child, was hard time. So we had this kind of depression now during this pandemic time. Maybe much worse than depression, because we cannot travel to different countries, to the different states, because of coronavirus. So we are like in balloon, only in our communities, to visit each other, to help each other, to encourage each other. This is very important. This is not normal time. Looking in your faces with masks, this is not our lifestyle, but we have to do this because of coronavirus. We have to do this because we love each other. So everybody should be healthy. But we are here to say thank you to Rose. This church should be packed for her funeral. But this is the reality. We cannot come too many people accept in this church. So we are offering prayer for this wonderful teacher, member of our Catholic community. I pray that Saint Cecilia, the patron of this church and the earlier community, will help her to open the door in heaven for Rose Mead. I wish young people to remember her as you put wonderful message, grandma's advice. If you are ever headed the wrong way in life, remember the road to heaven allows U-turns. Exactly. Very simple statement. But we should remember, sometimes we should return to God. You and me, yes, we are only people. We are weak people, but we want to be good people. And every funeral is a special sign for all of us, the living people on this earth. The time of death will come up. I am ready to see Jesus. I am doing good on this earth. Maybe if something wrong, I will put my hands together and ask Jesus, help me to be better and be merciful to me. This is funeral with some message. It's painful for the family, but for all of us, the living people, still message. Be careful. Your time on this earth is coming to the end. Are you ready? Are you happy to see Jesus? So, my dear friends, tomorrow is August 15, the Feast of the Assumption. So I put this vestment of the Blessed Mary because Rose, she loved the songs to the Blessed Virgin Mary. And thank you for this beautiful song, Gentlewoman. Your voice is like you, my dear, Nancy, the daughter of Rose
Matthew, David, thank you. Thank you. This is a wonderful gift. Gentlewoman. And Rose, many times she played many Blessed Mother's songs because we had many here devotion to the Blessed Mother. So my dear friends, please remember that we are children of God, like we heard in the second readings. Yes. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yes, so we are. Children of God, beautiful words. I wish you all to be good children of God, because everything is waiting for us in heaven. Now we are like walkers in the journey, step by step, closer to see Jesus. Oh Jesus, who are here, bless our life and reward the pain of Rose's family for her beautiful life to be good mother, wife, grandma, grandma, and teacher. Thank you for your presence. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her. Amen. Alleluia. Please arise for the petitions. With hope in the resurrection of Christ, and with deep sorrow in the loss of one we love, let us call on God, source of all kindness and comfort.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Rose Mead, who was given the promise of eternal life in baptism, and now is called to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the deceased members of the Mead Sapienza families, relatives, and friends, to be comforted and consoled in the grieving they are experiencing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have gathered here today, remembering our deceased, to continue to be supportive to one another in prayer and concern, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God to welcome into his glory those of our family and friends who have departed from this life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are present to bring their prayers and intentions held quietly in their hearts, to our Almighty Father, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayers for the ones we love. Give them eternal peace and joy in your heavenly kingdom forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. For the Lord has said, sacrifice. Amen. Pray for the glory of the name. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Rose, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May you holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them right out of fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate a memorial of his death and the resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also Rose, and her husband James, and brother Dominic, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Padre Pio, Saint Cecilia, Saint Patrick, Saint Joseph, Saint Rose, Our Lady of Fatima, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At our Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
for eulogy after eulogy will be meditation song. So eulogy. So Nancy and Jessica.
Something out of the ordinary, something different that she just, you know, had to deal with. And the social distancing, all of that. To the rest of our out of the country and out of our state family, we miss you, and we know that you're here with us in spirit. So to many, Mom was out of the ordinary. She was extraordinary. I heard, and last night I heard some different things. I heard her described as amazing, kind, brilliant, witty, hard worker, the Energizer Bunny, and the mayor. Everywhere we went around here, one I recall was the Batavia Downs to celebrate some birthdays, and she swore she had never been there. But as soon as we walked in, everybody, "Hi, Mrs. Mead, how are you, Mrs. Mead?" Okay, she was never there, but anyway. She would never have described herself as extraordinary. Well, maybe the Energizer Bunny, but probably none of the other stuff. But life in the fast lane was one of her mottos. And we've all heard the saying, it takes a village. Well, in my mother Rose Mead's case, one village wasn't quite enough to keep up with her. It took several. And I see some folks here from all of the villages. We have the village of Oakfield and her Padre Pio family, where she spent her entire life fully immersed in her community, her school, and her church activities, the historical society meetings. She took students to Montreal, Quebec City, France. She did. It was involved in Vacation Bible School, Religious Ed, RCIA. Music ministry was her special love. And by the way, our hymns today, a couple of them, were ones she continued to play every day up until she couldn't play the piano anymore. And a couple of these hymns had special names to her, and one she called the Sweet Potato Song, and the other was the Yoo-Hoo Song. And Ruth, you're here somewhere, right? Ruth would know. She was the other organist that Mom paled around with. And they went to a conference, and Dan Shuey was one of the composers, and he said he would never again write a song that started with "I am," that's the sweet potato one, and "Yoo-hoo," that was the On Eagle's Wings. To her Oakfield and Batavia family, church, school, historical society, friends, neighbors, former students, I thank you for being my eyes and ears for the past 10 and a half years. While she lived alone, you always looked out for her, you gave her rides, you fixed things for her. I especially liked when her neighbor Bill told me he could very easily just pull a little wire out of the car so it wouldn't start. So worry about her driving all over the place. Thank you for having tea and pork rinds with her, Karen. She especially loved that. For making pizza with her, and for putting in a small garden for her, none of these little acts went unnoticed. You included her in your chicken barbecues and many other enjoyable activities. She loved her social life. Mom was fiercely independent, and she treasured that freedom. Especially, like I said, taking off in her car to do her thing. If it weren't for you, she wouldn't have been able to stay in Oakfield as long as she did. And actually, it wasn't until a few days before she passed that she told Cliff and me she thought it was finally time for her to stay in Honeyard with us and not go back to Oldfield. And I said, that was a really good idea. And she was stubborn. Mom's second village was the village of Honeyoy in St. Mary's St. Matthew Church. She lived with us for almost 3 years, and we have wonderful friends and parishioners that welcomed and included her. She enjoyed any activity she attended there and jumped right into help. Thank you for the visits, the in-home haircuts, manicures, and when she could no longer get out, the treats you bring her. You all supported us in so many ways while she lived with us, and we can't thank you enough. Mom had two other villages keeping wonderful, watchful eyes on her and as we cared for her, and those were the Lifetime Care and Ontario Yates County Hospice. We could not have done it at home without your support. You came into our home, you became part of our family, and when Mom was rehabbing from falling and breaking her arm, struggling with losing her balance, you were there to torture her with the E-word exercise, not her favorite activity. And you guided us on how to safely assist her. Each and every one was amazing, and we can't thank you enough. Okay, this is the hard one. Last but certainly not least is our family village. We were all very important to her, and she was so proud of all her grandchildren and great-granddaughter, and another great-grandchild on the way. She loved playing music with you, teaching you, having all the family gatherings. She always wanted to be where the action was. One time she said, get me out of this bed so I can go where the action is. That's her, I know. Thank you for always being there, for taking her places, speaking Spanish with her, and hanging out with her. When Mom hadn't seen anyone for a bit, she always asked, is everyone where they're supposed to be? That's how she'd answer. And when COVID hit and the visits were fewer and farther between, she would ask if anyone was coming. And we would typically say something like, nope, it's just the Three Musketeers, Three Little Pigs, Three Stooges, or whatever we could come up with. And she'd come back with, well, I guess it's just Jacobo. That was Big Jacob, and that was Cliff. And then there was Yaquino, and that was Little Jacob, and that was her. And then there was Panzamoda, and you had to say these words just right, or you were corrected. And Panzamoda was soft stomach, and that was me. Maybe she thought I needed an ab workout. But anyway, Mom thought she heard one of her uncles or something say that. So that stuck. Mommy had lots of other Rose-isms, as we call them. A couple of them were, and we hope you all took a rock back there, but she loved words, and she once said, words are like toys to me, I love playing with them. She loved reading her newspapers, lots of newspapers, and the Reader's Digest, and doing crossword puzzles, and the cash word lottery tickets, and she could spot any misspelled word on any sign, any book. She even found a misspelling on a lottery ticket. And she often said she should have gotten a job as a proofreader in her retirement. Joan and Judy helped me with the program, my Honeyoy people, and we made sure we proofed that thing at least 8 times before we sent it here to Debbie, because she wouldn't like it if there was a typo in it. Anyway, Mom was particularly not fond of being vertically challenged. Another ism she used to, on occasion, when some of her students or anyone would comment on her height, was, and I know some of you have heard this before, real height is the distance between your ears. And she made sure you knew what that really meant. She was little, but she was mighty. There are many other Rose-isms I could go on and on, but I'll stop and save some for Jesse. But before I turn it over to her, I need to thank Justin Clarko Smith from the Burdett and Sanford Funeral Home. From the moment he came into our house on April 3rd to take Mom, and right up until today, he's been nothing short of an honest and caring person, very professional and compassionate, and has become one of my rocks. Throughout the numerous phone, text, and email exchanges, Justin responded quickly and he gave me peace of mind. He even convinced me to take Mom home and let her hang out on the piano where she loved to be. And he even texted me in the morning to remember to bring her. Because I was worried about that. So thank you again, Justin. Thank you, Mom, for always being there for us, for loving and teaching us, for instilling your amazing and exemplary work ethic and high standards, strength, faith, spirit, and sense of humor. We miss you and love you, Rosebuds.
Hi. Thanks for finding a way to be here today. I know she did a lot of thank yous, but it's nice we can all finally be together for this. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Jessie Andrus. I am Nancy's daughter and one of Rose's 6 grandkids, 7 if you count her great-granddaughter. And I know I speak for my siblings and cousins in saying how lucky we all feel to have grown up with Grandma in our lives. When thinking about what we wanted to say today, it became very clear that there was a lot that we had to say. Always another memory, story, song, recipe, or witty one-liner came up. And before I knew it, we just had pages and pages to sift through. The thing about our grandma is that she was full of life and love and knowledge, and she always shared that with us. Like my mom said, for as long as I can remember, my grandma was the queen of proofreading. You could always count on her to point out an error in the newspaper, magazine, billboard, anywhere. And like it or not, she always corrected our grammar growing up. She eagerly proofread our papers all throughout high school and even in college. She would ask to look at them. And I attribute this to her love for language and her career as a teacher, which I would often tell her that she passed on the teacher gene to me because I am a teacher now myself. So in true teacher-like fashion, there was a lot of planning, editing, and practicing that went into what to say to you today. The result is a letter to our grandma that I want to read for her and share with you. And hopefully the proofreading's up to her standards. Dear Grandma, prepare yourself for a love-filled letter from your grandkids that's all about you. I'm sure you won't be surprised that we have a lot to say. Don't cringe or roll your eyes too hard. It's mostly the good stuff. We have a lot that we want to say thank you for, and a lot of things we'll always remember. It would be impossible to fit all of it into one letter, but we wanted to highlight a few. Thank you, first, for always being there. From birthdays to graduations, recitals, holidays, weekend visits, or sitting through endless basketball and soccer games, even though we knew you weren't really that into sports. We could always count on you to be there. As we got older, you continued to be there through weddings, buying first homes, your great-granddaughter's birthday parties, or as you like to say it, supervising social gatherings at the house. You had some sayings we could expect to hear every time we were with you, such as, "Wow, it took hours to make all this food and we're done in 10 minutes. Or, "How tall are you? Are you still growing?" And Sylvia remembers that you always called her Tootsie Bella. You put up with our pets, snuggling in by your feet, and you were even a good sport when we asked you to come on wine tours, try Snapchat filters, or even take a celebrity shot in beer pong. We'd like to add that she did it underhanded and totally nailed it her first try. It was a good memory. You always found a way to participate and had a smile on your face. And we loved having you there to make those memories. We want to say thank you for your support and value of family. Through good times and bad, you were always there to listen and spend time with us, support us, and offer words of encouragement when needed. You were wise, smart, and always there to offer perspective. Thank you for passing on several traditions and recipes that go back to your Italian roots. Some dishes that will forever remind us of you are homemade pasta, gnocchi, cannolis, pina colada, cardoons, Texas sheet cake, sfingis, and pizzelles. We still think you might be the only Italian in the history of Italians that doesn't like onions, garlic, or tomatoes. But we knew that you always wanted your food plain Jane. Thank you for showing us what it meant to be part of a community, visiting you in Oakfield, or eventually when you started your life in Honeyway, it was hard to go anywhere without someone stopping to say hi to you. There were former students who would call you Mrs. Mead, you had neighbors, friends from church or the historical society who eagerly stopped to have a chat with you. You were very involved and well known. You might not love this one, but like it or not, we'll always remember you as a saver. You saved everything. Egg cartons, jars, toilet paper rolls, Tupperware, buttons, plastic bags, which, believe it or not, are kind of hard to come by now. You said that you never know when you might need something, and we always knew where to go if we did. We'll always remember your ability to effortlessly play the piano, read music, or play a song from memory at the drop of a dime. You loved music and encouraged our musical abilities in every way. Even if that meant during church, sometimes she would just open the hymn book and shove it at us if we weren't singing. She was always there to give us that nudge. We'll always remember our friends telling us how cute you were, which, of course, you were cute. You were 4'9" at your tallest, small and smiling and adorable. But those of us who really knew you, we know that size, you didn't let size dictate your personality. You were witty, unfiltered, sassy, and always full of things to say. You had a great sense of humor and were as stubborn as it gets. An example of how stubborn she was: persistence on blackberry picking well into your 90s. You refused to pass up on some big berries that were far in the back, and that meant taking a little spill and ending up with the burns on your arm. Or that time when we were teenagers and you found one of our Cosmopolitan magazines and read every word front to back. That was embarrassing. Thank you for showing us the value of education and keeping a sharp mind. Watching episodes of Jeopardy with you or seeing you complete a crossword puzzle was amazing. You could come up with answers to things we had never heard of before. And not many people's grandmas know English, French, Spanish, Italian, and Latin. You loved language, words, and were the true definition of a lifelong learner. So now is the hard part of the letter, the part where we say goodbye. And acknowledge that even though you aren't here, you'll always be with us. We like to think that Grandpa is right back to calling you Mrs. Murphy and sneaking up behind you to give you a kiss. Know that we miss you and think of you every day. Thank you for filling our lives with love. Love your grandkids.
Thank you very much for the wonderful words of your mother and grandmother. Now we have the song Ave Maria.
Thank you.
time she told me, so when she was a college student, so some sister from Batavia, from Polish parish, Saint Sacred Heart, because that time was a very strong Polish parish, Sacred Heart in Batavia, and one time bishop are coming to visit the parish, you know, the Sacred Heart parish, and he was speaking Polish. So the sister, the nun, asked her, Rose, because you are you are speaking, you know, in Italian, and also, you know, Latin, so Polish language is between Latin and Italian. So you can welcome Bishop, you know, in Polish. I will prepare for you the text, what you should say, then you will read for me. So Rose told me it was very hard because Polish language is different, but if sister told me so between Latin and Italian, Polish language, I will read. So she did it. So this is the reason what kind of person she was. Because they knew her, she was very active as a student and speaking some languages. So this is the reason why you can even be asked to do something in different languages. So thank you, Rose. So you welcome some bishop in Polish language. Thank you. Thank you, Rosary Society, for beautiful gift of rosary for the soul of the Rose, and thank you, our choir. Thank every one of you for coming here to say goodbye to Rose. Let us have prayer. Lord God, whose Son left us the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant us, strengthened by it, our sister Rose Mead may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Lord, save your people. By your coming as man, Lord,
save your people.
By your birth,
Lord, save your people.
By your baptism and fasting,
Lord, save your people.
By your sufferings and cross,
Lord, save your people.
By your rising to new life,
Lord, save your people.
By your returning glory to the Father,
Lord, save your people.
By your gift of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, save your people.
By your coming again in glory,
Lord, save your people.
Father, into your hands we commend our sister Rose. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, she will be raised to life at the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave her in this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our sister Rose to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angel lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you. Take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the grace of all who believe in you, and even though their bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Give our sister Rose peace for us in this grave, until the day when you, the resurrection, the life, will raise her up in glory. Then may she see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, the kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray for our sister Rose, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who says, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Lord, you raise the dead to life. Give our sister Rose eternal life. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear our prayer. Our sister Rose was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give her fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our sister Rose. Let our faith be our consolation, and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you have overcome death for us. Through his burial and the resurrection from the dead, you have made the grave a holy place and restored to us eternal life. We pray for those who died believing in Jesus and buried with him in the hope of rising again. God of the living and the dead, may those who faithfully believe in you on earth praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. O God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it. As we bury here the ashes of the soul of Rose, from deliver her from every bond of sin, that she may rejoice in you with your saints forever. Amen. Let us pray. Faithful God, Lord of all creation, you desire that nothing redeemed by your Son will ever be lost, and that the just will be raised up on the last day. Comfort us today with the word of your promise as we return the ashes of our sister Rose to the earth. Grant Rose a place of rest and peace where the world of dust and ashes has no dominion. Confirm us in our hope that she will be created anew on the day when you will raise her up in glory to live with you and all the saints forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
Amen. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my dear family, Nancy, and your wonderful kids, and your family, your brother and family. So this is a beautiful day, even from heaven, for Rose. This is, everything is working. If you are very close to Blessed Mother, to heaven, even the weather is working. My dear friends, thank you for participation. Be good, doing something. Maybe you have some gifts of her languages, to use it in your life, especially if, maybe you are a teacher or some family members, so it would be a good idea. And if you love music, do it. Oh, music is beautiful. You have a beautiful voice, so your mother will be happy today.
Yeah. Thank you. I hope so.
Thank you, and be strong and healthy. God bless you. My deepest sympathy to
Thank
all
you.
Of you. Thank you.
Thank you.